Ranger has announced 12 new colors in the Distress line of products. January 2015 kicks the year off with the release of Cracked Pistachio. There will be a new color each month for the duration of the year, though the colors will not be announced prior to their release, leaving us with lots to anticipate over the next 11 months. So here we are with Cracked Pistachio front and center, the star of January. And my initial thought was within the Distress line, I wanted to find some colors that it works really well with. Now, if we look at a color wheel, we'd see that virtually everything that I have here right now is on the same side. These are colors that are pretty much adjacent to this greenish-blue color that is Cracked Pistachio. So with that in mind, you really can't go wrong with virtually any of these. The only place where you might get into some trouble is if you overuse the brushed pewter, but I'm going to show you how you can use that as an accent and it'll be fine. So let's go ahead and take the caps off of these, and what I want to do is just a little bit of spraying so you can see how this works. Now, in the case of picket fence, anytime you put picket fence on something, because it's a semi-opaque product, it's going to create a pastel version, which is really cool too. So let's start with, we've got Peacock Feathers and Mowed Lawn to go with Cracked Pistachio. The group of colors that I'm working with, in addition to Cracked Pistachio, are Mowed Lawn, Evergreen Bough, Tumble Glass, Peacock Feathers, I mentioned Picket Fence, and Brushed Pewter for a metallic look. So I'm going to start by just spritzing a little bit, and how pretty is this color? It really rides the fence between green and blue, and depending on whether you put greens with it or blues with it, you'll find that it looks one way or the other. So it's a really, really nice color. I'm going to come in with a little bit of Peacock Feather, so I'm going to go kind of dark here, then I'm going to come in with a little bit of Mowed Lawn, and you can see that this works really, really well. Now I can mist this with some water if I want to get some more running going on. This is just a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper. If I think I've gotten a little bit too far away from the Cracked Pistachio color, it's a simple matter of going ahead and adding some more. So let's just pop this out of the way for a second, and though it kills me to mop this up and not use it on someplace else, in the interest of getting this done so you can see it and then you can get it and try it yourself, let's come back with some more of the Cracked Pistachio. Now these are obviously pretty small pieces of paper, but this time I'm going to go a little bit lighter. I'm going to use Tumble Glass, and you can see, again, just a beautiful combination. Now Evergreen Bough is going to be a little bit deeper, but I can come in and just put a little bit on there, and you can see that it kind of grays things down. So that's a way that this works. Again, let me get that out of the way. Now, there are certainly going to be other colors that this will work with, other colors within the Distress line, but initially, this was my thought, and I wanted to show you how easy it is to go ahead and work with these colors. This time, I'm going to come back with a little bit more of the Tumble Glass, but I'm going to spray some of the brushed pewter on there. Now, because this is a metallic, you do have to shake it to activate the mixing ball so that the color is all well, and of course, there we go. So I've got my nozzle is a little bit funky, so it sprayed out this stream, but it made a really cool effect, so I'm not going to object too much to that. But again, silver and blues and greens is a beautiful combination, so this is really easy. And then I could come in with some some picket fence if I want. And again, the semi-opaque nature of picket fence, you can see what happens when the color starts to get on here. And obviously you can cause running and dripping. You can use a little bit of water or not to kind of make that move a little bit more. So here's the Distress spray stain in Cracked Pistachio. We're going to look at the regular stains and some of the other products in just a moment. There are lots of ways to use Distress stain in the original Dauber Top bottle, and I'm going to show you a couple of my favorites right now. Obviously, we're focusing on Cracked Pistachio, so I'm back. I'm going to use Tumble Glass. What do I have here? This is Peacock Feathers, and then I have some Mowed Lawn. In some place here, I have some of the Brushed Pewter, because I want to bring that in and show you how you can put some metallic in there. So again, with the Brushed Pewter, you need to go ahead and give this a shake so the mixing ball can do its work. Now for this technique, what I'm going to do is put some color down on my surface, and again, I have nonstick craft sheet here. So I need to get enough liquid down here to actually make this technique work. I don't have a very big piece of paper, but I still need to get some color down there. So I'm going to use a little bit of Mowed Lawn. It's pretty dark, so I don't want to get too heavy with that color. Then I'm going to bring in some Peacock Feathers, and you'll notice I'm trying to spread my color blobs out so that they're not all concentrated in the same place. Now Tumble Glass is pretty light. I don't know how much of that we'll see, but we'll go ahead and throw a little bit in here. And then I'm going to put down a little bit of the Brushed Pewter. because again, silver works so beautifully with these colors. Now I've got a fair amount of liquid on here. I'm going to give it just the tiniest little spritz of water, just so that there's enough to actually make it do what I need it to. Again, I'm coming back with a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper, and all I'm going to do is swipe and kind of drag the paper through the puddles that are on here. And you can see how beautiful this is. Again, really nice colors. You can see the metallic in there from the brushed pewter. Let me just bring in my heated craft tool. I'm going to dry this, and then I'm going to come back and show you the next step, which is to go ahead and to dip back into what's already there. My piece is dry enough now that I can come back and add the next layer, and I like to just kind of place this in and let it pick up the dots or blobs of color, and you can see how beautiful that texture becomes when you start pressing like this. You can get all kinds of various dimensions and all kinds of really fun effects. When I'm working on small pieces, I really like to make backgrounds like this. I think that they're really beautiful. Now this piece, once I dry it, I can cut it up and use it for any number of things. But for now, I'm going to put it to one side because I want to show you something else that I really like to do with the dauber top bottles. Let's just get that out of the way so it's not going to be right in the middle of things. Now, this is one that I've already started. You all know that I love borders. I think that they really make a page look finished. I like the framing effect that you get. So this was peacock feathers, and this is our cracked pistachio around the outer edge here. I'm going to show you one just the opposite with the cracked pistachio on the inside, and we'll put something along here on the outside. So when I do this, I don't sketch anything to begin with. All I'm going to do is basically work with the bottle of cracked pistachio almost like a brush. This time I think I'm just going to do a rectangular design. Now I haven't squeezed really hard on this bottle, although there is plenty in the dauber top, so it's dispensing without any difficulty. But I can, if when I want to come along and fill this in, what I need to do is go ahead and squeeze a little bit. Now this isn't going to be a very perfect rectangle. If you wanted something that was a little bit more uniform, obviously you would pay a little bit more attention than I am at the moment and do a little bit of a better job. Now in order to get, let's just square that up a little bit. In order to get this center seam, what I like to do is just put a little bit of the color out on the worksheet. I can grab a brush, and that allows me to just go ahead and pick the color up, and I can go ahead and continue this line across the span where the signatures are sewn into the journal. I'm working with one of the Strathmore art journals. They really are my favorite. You have to work hard in order to get this journal to bleed through the signature. Sorry, sometimes I can't talk and work at the same time. You have to work really hard to get this to bleed through the signatures. Not only are they sewn, but they're glued. This is a Smith sewn binding, so it works really, really well. Now, before I go ahead and put my border color on, I need to dry the centerpiece, because if I hit wet on wet, it's going to wick and I'm going to get color bleeding in from this outside border. Now that can be deliberate if that's what you want to do, but in this case I want to substantially separate the two borders so that they don't run one into another. So let me dry this and then I'll come back and I'll show you how to go ahead and just add the outside border on. With the center part of the spread dry, I'm going to come back with tumble glass and see how that looks. That's going to make for a pretty light border and a light page overall. If I think that this is not dark enough, I can certainly come back and add something else. Oops. So what I'm going to do is just stick a little paper under here so that I don't wet the subsequent pages on here. I want to contain the color to just this one spread. This is just kind of an easy way to do that. And now I would do the same thing along here. I would bring the brush back in with the tumbled glass so that I could catch this center area where the pages are tight in against one another, and that would allow me to get the color in. But you can see that when you have a dauber top like this, it really does help you control the application of the color. You can't do anything like this with a spray. Now, obviously a spray has its benefits, and I'm not at all debating that. What I'm just saying is that the dauber top bottle gives you lots of really nice options. And if you watched the video that I did that compared and asked the question, do we still need the dauber top bottles once the distressed colors were available in the sprays, you know that I said yes, I felt that this was still a very important product, and obviously Ranger thinks so because they went ahead and they released cracked pistachio in this color as well. So we have paint left, and then I'm going to show you ink pad, the marker, and of course re-inking is just simply re-inking the pad, but this color is available across all of the Distress products. I really enjoy working with Distress paint to create what I call my scribble flowers, and primarily it's just making scribbly circles on a sheet of 90-pound watercolor paper with various colors of paint, and then either drawing the flowers on by hand or using our scribble flower stamps, but we'll get there. The most important thing is that we've got cracked pistachio front and center again, and it's the star of January, so it's the star of this particular group of scribble flowers. What I do is take a color or colors and I make rows of circles, and it's very straightforward. Let me just grab another piece of watercolor paper here and I can show you how I start. So all I would do would be to take the paint. Now what you don't want to do when you press this down and you have color coming out, you can see there's a little bit of color there, when you have color coming out of the dabber top, you don't want to flood it. What you want is this kind of scratchy look that you get here, and the way that you get that is by not having a ton of paint in the dabber top. And you can apply more pressure both to the pressure on the dabber top, or you can squeeze, which will dispense paint out of the valve into the top, or you can just kind of go really lightly like this and whatever happens happens. And you, the nice thing is because Distress is going to dry permanently, it means that once this group of pistachio, cracked pistachio circles is dry, I can layer any color over that I want over the top, for example purple, and I'm still going to have discrete layers of purple and of cracked pistachio. That's the nice thing. The colors are not going to blend. They're simply going to layer one on top of the other. Now, I like to do this with at least three colors, and sometimes, depending on how much I'm playing, you can come back and you can do four or five if you want. So, for example, this is dry. I could come back. This is peacock feathers. I could come back. I need to just get this going slightly. I could come back and add another layer here so that I have another color. Same thing here. So when you work with, ordinarily, let's say you were working with purple and green, you wouldn't want them to mix together because you'd get a fairly unpleasant muddy color, but that's not going to happen with the Distress paint. Now, obviously, this is just the barest thing that you can do with Distress paint, but since it's one of my favorites, I did want to show this to you. So, with that said, I like to use, well, again, here's our scribble flower. This is two, this is three, and the little one is one. I like to use stays-on ink because nothing is going to move it once it's on there. It's going to produce a nice permanent finish, or stamp, if you will. So all I'm going to do is stamp with black stays-on right on there. Let's bring in the bigger number three flower. I don't actually have a lot of really big areas on here, but you get the idea of how this, whoops, you get the idea of how this works. If you find that the cling on the back of your stamp has a bunch of stuff on it, like mine does, put a little bit of water on it, and then that will help it adhere to the block. Now I need to re-ink this, because obviously I had my fingers on there, but it will stay in place now. All right, so let's turn this over and let's kind of come in here. We're going to have to sacrifice the ones around it, but you get the impression. So you can go ahead and stamp the scribble flowers like this, and then once you do, what I like to do is come in. I like to use, this is the Sharpie water-based paint marker, and this is white. I'm not going to do too much here only because the background there is light enough that you're probably not going to see it. But I'm going to come in and just touch this into these dots, and I like to make white dots, and then I like to make colored dots. But of course, you know, you can do anything that you like. Everybody has their idea about the way these things should be. So what I can do is I'll bring in a jelly roll metallic pen, and I can come in and do the larger circles here. But using the scribble flower stamps makes it really easy because all the hard work, all the actual drawing has been done, so you get to do the fun stuff, which is play with color and then color them in afterward. So again, cracked pistachio is a beautiful color when you combine it with the purples and with the blues and even with the pinks. You can get a really interesting range of scribble flowers. Let's finish with the final three products in cracked pistachio. I have the ink pad and the re-inker and the Distress marker. And you can see I've got our Joggles Mickey stamp set up on a piece of watercolor paper. He doesn't come with this hat, but it's super easy to draw one. This is the way he comes as you stamp him, and what I've done is just put this hat on him because I think he looks great with it. When I think of cracked pistachio, it's a really nice mild green color that doesn't scream grass green, it doesn't scream yellow green, but it certainly says St. Patrick's Day to me. So with that in mind, I've got Mickey ready to go, and I want to show you how easy it is to watercolor using the markers. So I have an empty water brush, and I'm just going to scribble a little bit of the cracked pistachio out onto my nonstick craft sheet. And I'm going to pick up the color with the water brush, and here's the easy part. Let the water do the work for you. Let it blend the color and dilute it a little bit if you don't want it super dark, and just go ahead and lay the color down. It's like paint by number. It's so easy. You can get a little bit more creative if you want. You can add shadows and highlights, or you can just literally block in color, and it presents a really, really nice look. Now, as with the stains and the spray stains, the colors that are going to work really well with this that are quite effortless are going to be peacock feathers and tumble glass. Mowed lawn works beautifully with it. And so you can use the same colors that we talked about earlier, but bear in mind that this is not the only group of colors that work with cracked pistachio. And once I've had a chance to play with it a little more, I'll show you some other color combinations that I think work really well. But you can see how quickly that goes along, and it really does present a really nice watercolor look. Again, you sort of make this hat, you put them on here. If you're going to make St. Patrick's Day cards, if you need something else green themed, then I think that cracked pistachio is perfect for that. So that's going to leave us with the ink pad and the reinker. Now the reinker is straightforward. When this pad needs some help, when it's stamped as much as it's going to do for you, and I'm not going to put this on because this is a brand new stamp pad, but what you'll do is you'll take an eyedropper full of the reinker and you're going to spread it over here and let it soak in. If the pad is really, really dry, you might need to add another half eyedropper full, but you shouldn't really need to do that. So with that said, let's look at stamping. First of all, it's pretty obvious. It's an ink pad. You can stamp with it. This is our background noise leaves stamp. This is the spread that you saw me work on with the distress stain in the dauber top. You saw me do this a little bit earlier. So again, even though I'm using the same color over what I've already put on here, it shows up perfectly well, so you can do some really fun background things. But a stamp pad is made for more than just stamping. You can certainly do more with it than that. So if I bring in some tumble glass and some mowed lawn and maybe some peacock feathers, what I can do is just go ahead and put some of the cracked pistachio down, and then I'm going to add some of these other colors. Now, will you contaminate the ink pads if you cross this over? Probably, but honestly, it makes so little difference, it's not going to really matter. So I'm going to bring in some of the peacock feathers because it's going to be a darker blue, and then I'm going to bring in a little bit of the mowed lawn because it's going to be a darker green. And then once I do this, it's a matter of just going ahead and spritzing some water on there. You see the reaction that happens. Again, just a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper, but you can do all kinds of fun things. Now, there's lots of ways that you can do backgrounds with this. This is just one example, but if you find yourself short of a color and you want to do some backgrounds and you have that color in an ink pad, then obviously this is a really great way to go about it. So cracked pistachio, as I said, it's a really nice middle green. I don't find it super blue. I don't find it super green. What I do find it is a really super nice color, and I know that I'm going to enjoy using it quite a lot, and I think that you'll see this turning up. It's such a pretty color, and it works so well with greens and blues that I think you're going to see this in my work quite often.